your sister, your brother. Take it back,
take it back, take it back, take it back.
Hey, family, real quick. What I need y'all to do is really quickly go into your group chats, go into your team chats, go into your personal downline chats. And what I need y'all to do is go ahead and send this link out to three individuals who you know that's going to need these breakthroughs, the sauce, the value that's going to be spilled onto us and overflowing for us tonight, guys. So let's go ahead. We're going to get this call started up very soon. I want to get this thing up and rolling immediately. So, yo, go ahead, send the link out. We're going to get value on tonight for you guys and you guys only. So, let's grow, family. If you guys can hear me, if y'all can see me, what I need you to do is drop some motherfucking ones in the chat box tonight. Cause yo, I'm so happy, grateful. Get this call off rolling, started. Get the sauce overflow. Yo, that's fire. That's fire. That's what's up. I see them flooding. Damn, y'all gonna have to call me Chef Boyardee with the sauce that we got for y'all tonight. And yo, I'm so happy, grateful. So those of you who do not know me, right? Who's this random kid screaming at me? My name is Cesar Rivera, aka Cesar God, right? And I am a platinum leader within Trade House. And what I honestly believe is the next up and coming, you know, team within IM, CBC, right? And I really just want, love and appreciate every single one of y'all for hopping onto this call. We are 35 deep, but I know we're going to get this call packed out, damn near 70 plus by the end of it. Because, yo, the special guest that we have on tonight is someone that we cannot take for granted. And I need y'all to really understand what's going to happen tonight. There's going to be nothing shy of breakthroughs, abundance, and knowledge that will be given to us. Y'all got to understand, damn near for free and out of this individual's comfort time, right? Because low-key, it's late, right? We all were working earlier. We all were maybe at school earlier, right? We all had our previous obligations before this. So I'm not going to lie to y'all, right? This time period isn't for everybody to hop on Money Heist calls, right? This time period is for the grinders, those who truly want to create generational wealth, those who truly want to make this trading shit work, right? Excuse the language, but I get so passionate about this because there's people who want this and there's people who need this, right? People who genuinely want this to happen for them, not just for them, for their friends, their family, their community, right? Y'all don't understand. And tonight is going to be the next stepping stone to that goal. Right, y'all gotta really understand and appreciate the individual who's gonna be pouring onto us tonight. He has done so many things on and in the back office for not just Go Live, but for Tradehouse, right? For all of us to be here, be the snipers that we are in these markets, right? We literally are gonna be learning from one of the best traders that I personally look up to, right? The man who has literally given me so many breakthroughs, not by just simply not by just simply giving me the best entry based off the 88.672 Fib level, not because you have to look for this exact institutional candle pattern of engulfing candles. No, it's because he puts so much emphasis that the foundation, right? What is the simplicity of trading is what truly and effortlessly works, right? The man literally pours onto us every single Monday, talking nothing shy of your trading plan. Right, he literally takes a day just to explain to us just the simplicity of trading, how simple this game really is. And it is us who makes this truly more complicated than it needs to be, right? So y'all, I need y'all to go ahead, because this man already does 3 calls for us on his own channel every single week on Go Live, right? He not only does that, he pops on every single, every single bounce back session to pour into us. Right, he does multiple calls for us just so we can be a little bit of a better sniper, right? Or just have a better understanding of what is it the US dollar is going to do, the gold is going to do, right? Anything for us, right? So family, what I need y'all to do is show this man the utmost respect, right? Show this man the utmost effort, right? Make sure you have your notebooks ready, your pens ready, cameras on, right? Because I don't know about him, personally me. I love looking at myself. I'll do that all day, but I get tired of looking at myself on a Zoom call, right? So I would love to see so many beautiful names. I want to see all the beautiful faces too, right? But family, I'm going to go ahead and step out of the way of greatness, right? And pass it on to my brother, right? The man who inadvertently taught me a little bit of Tamil, right? Something like that. I promise y'all, I pay attention though, right? So yo, my brother, the GOAT. Yo, bro, Siva, if you here, bro, and you ready to pour onto us, my bro, yo, the stage is yours, broski.
Yo, I feel like I'm about to like hop into a boxing ring mat right now, bro. Like, you got me amped up, bro. Like, I'm ready to body somebody. Like, that was fire. You know, I appreciate you, bro. You know, it's honestly powerful to see how much this organization has grown, to see individuals like yourself. You know, it's honestly crazy. And I'm honestly grateful to be here. I'm grateful to be here with each and every single one of y'all. Really, before I dive into things, I just, you know, for some of the people that might be new here or don't even know who I am, I want to give a quick introduction on myself, of course. But, you know, like he said as well, let's see some more cameras on, right? I see one row. You know, I appreciate you, RJ. I appreciate you, Thomas. Nadia, thank you for the cameras. Abby, thank you. See, we got Natalie here driving on with her camera on. Like, come on. If you ain't on the toilet or something like that, you should have your camera on right now. All right. But, you know, like Caesar was saying, you know, my name is Siva. I've been a part of Tradehouse and IM Academy here for 3 years, moving into 4 years now. February 26th will be my 4-year anniversary. You know, I actually used to be an Amazon driver prior to this. You know, I used to deliver packages for a living. Prior to that, I was delivering some other packages that I can't be talking about, but that's what, I really did. Now, the reason why I even got into trading, Familia, was, you know, the main reason why was because in January of 2019, my mom turned 65 years old. And you guys obviously know that's the age of retirement. And due to our financial situations at home, she obviously wasn't able to do that, right? And just working at Amazon wasn't cutting it. You know, I was only making a set amount of money every single month. So if I were to retire my mother, I obviously need to bring in another stream of income. And that's when, you know, my boy, RJ, you know, somebody that, you know, I grew up with, I learned a lot from, you know, big shout out to him. he's the one that put me on and introduced me to Zach, right? I was able to meet Zachary Hogan when prior to him moving to Texas, right? And that's when my journey really started, right? And it's been wild to see where I started and where I'm at today and where I'm going to be going into the future. And really all I have to say to any single one of y'all in here, I'm not anybody different than any of y'all. You know, all I have is a drive to win and a drive to hustle and grind. And if y'all feel me in that same type of way, you can do this too. Because even when I was working at Amazon, guess what? Your boy was one of the top five drivers in that station, right? When I was doing other things, I was still one of the toppest people. That's all it is, right? The hustle and grind just continues into whatever avenue or whatever you do, right? Greatness in everything, exactly, right? So, you know, my journey has been wild. A lot of ups, a lot of downs, really, to be honest with y'all. But the main thing that, you know, I kind of want to really bring up on this call, and I obviously want to open it up to all of y'all as well, because, you know, I talk, like Caesar said, you know, I talk about charts. You know, I got my Monday, Wednesday, and Friday streams, but on top of that, I'm on Bounce Back too. So you're like, y'all have me five times a week, right? So, you know, if there is chart-related stuff, by all means, you guys can drop that stuff in the chat as well. But, you know, if you guys have any questions in general, right? Zoom is more intimate with the individual compared to Go Live, right? So take advantage of this time that you have with me to ask any particular questions that y'all might have. It could be about trading. It could be about psychology. It could be about, you know, just how I move on a day-to-day basis. So as we progress through this call, you know, write down some questions in the chat and I'll do the best that I can, obviously, address those as I move along with today's call, right? But what I really want to talk about with y'all right now, and because we're nearing into literally the last month of 2022. Okay. One more month left. And we are then going into 2023. Now, before I really dive in, you know, I want to ask one question to y'all, right? How long have y'all been here and how long have you been trading? Just so I can get a gist of, you know, where everybody's at, right? Because I want y'all to understand, like I said, you know, I've been doing this for almost 4 years now. And one of the biggest things that I've learned from this journey is consistency. Right? But consistency, what does that mean to you? What does consistency mean to y'all? Right? Because to me, consistency is about educating myself on it. If we're just talking about trading, right? Or even this entrepreneurial journey in general, right? What does that mean? Right? For me, myself, consistency is waking up in the morning, right? On time, making sure I'm behind the charts, doing my, you know, my morning ritual, which really isn't much. I fill up my water bottle with cold water and I chug this and I get on my computer and I get to work. That's my day. Like, I don't do anything special. I don't do anything crazy. You know, I usually have a podcast playing, usually in the morning, depending on the morning, if I need, or depending on the rising, I need to get that vocabulary out of my mouth. But, you know, once I start in the rising, you know, I got a podcast, something going and I'm on the charts and I'm getting in, right? 6 a.m. Central time is usually when I get up, but I'm literally doing that every single day, Monday to Friday. Does that mean I need to take a position every single day? No. Some of y'all probably see my Instagram and you're probably like, wow, this guy takes a trade almost every day. I don't. Sometimes I do, but not all the time, right? But that's the thing. I'm getting myself ready to go every single morning, right? After that, what am I doing? Well, you guys already know I have the bounce back session. I'll hop on that, go about doing that, yada, yada. But what else am I doing? Some of y'all know me as an educator, but I'm also a student, right? You guys will see me on every single Go Live. I'm literally in the chat. For the ones that are consistently on Jordan's streams, the ones that are consistently on Power Hour, I'm on there all the time. And that's what I really want to bring up to y'all, right? Because I think that a lot of individuals that start this, or even get into it a year and a half, 2 years. You know, I see individuals been here for 3 years, right? 8 months, right? We got a span of all different types of time frames here that people are in and out of. But the main thing that I want you all to understand is, you know, don't go with that euphoric thinking, right, of being invincible. Because some of y'all might have traded retail before, and now you're learning smart money. And now that you've learned smart money, you're building a euphoric idea. You know, you're happy that you learned this. You're like, oh my God, I'm crushing the charts. I'm doing amazing. You know, you start to build a little bit of an ego, right? We all know that word, right? E-G-O, right? Ego. You're like, yo, I know smart money. I'm getting sniper entries. You know, I got no drawdown. You know, y'all know that type of feeling. But let me tell y'all something. I've been there and I've done that. And that type of thinking is not a teachable, coachable type of thinking. Because the second you think that way, now you start to let off the gas on your habits. Because at the end of the day, we all understand that our habits are what make our progression in our life. So this is what I'm saying. Still till this day, other than probably maybe like 10 sessions in the last 4 years, right? I have not missed go live. I'm still hopping on. I'm still waking up regularly. I'm still educating myself. I still read. I'm still educating myself on trading books for the ones that have been following on my sessions. If you guys have not, I know this is just the cover. I don't like leaving my book. You know, I always take this off because I want to keep it all snazzy and stuff. But this book right here, for the ones that have been on my session, y'all really want to learn how to trade? Cop this book, right? Trade's about to happen. Literally this right here, right? Reading books, right? Continuously educating myself, backtesting, right? Not only backtesting, but actually applying. See, we are in the game of trading, okay? How do you perfect your, or not perfect, but how do you grow your trading? How do you get continuous results in your trading? You got to apply, right? A lot of y'all will hop on the go live session. And if I'm hitting you in a type of way, it's meant to hurt, right? I'm really rah-rah. I don't beat around the bush, all right? But this is what I'm saying right now is, If y'all are hopping on these go live sessions, you're doing all of this, that's only one part of the equation. Hopping on go live is only one thing, right? You got to be applying the actual skill set. And what that means is physically taking trades, right? If you're just hopping on the go lives and you're learning, you're taking notes, that doesn't get us anywhere. And guess what? There's a whole school system that's designed this way of learning. There's a reason why people that follow the regular school system only get so far in life, right? We're doing something that 1% of people in the world are doing. And the only way you guys are going to get progressive results in this is with hands-on experience. That's actually physically executing trades, taking trades. This needs to happen, okay? So I'm going to start sharing some of my habitual patterns that I do. Right. And I've already shared some of them, but I'm going to continue to share some of my habitual patterns that I do to consistently stay progressing in this career that I'm building here. Right. Number one, like I said, continuously staying educated. Okay. That's number one. Right. How many go lives y'all really hopping on? And if you can hop on a go live session live, make the recordings. But I would really highly recommend y'all to make sure you're on a live session, because live hits different than a recording. Right? You can actually ask questions, get engagement from the educator, whereas just simply, you know, hopping on a session and learning something. Number two, actually physically apply what y'all are learning from these sessions. You know, if you guys hop on my session, you guys know I've been talking a lot about volume and Wyckoff. How many of y'all have actually been? Some of y'all probably don't even know what volume is. If you haven't been, then you need to hop on the session because y'all sleeping, right? That's the thing, right? This is the main thing that I want you all to understand, right? We obviously know, even in the academy, we've seen a lot of people leave in this last 6 months to a year. Well, a lot of those people that left don't have the sauce that we have right now. The people that stayed understand what we've learned in the last 6 months, and now y'all are benefiting from it. this is what happens. And this is one of the biggest quotes that I've learned from Vargas, right? And, you know, and it's, you sit at the table long enough, you are going to eat and you will continuously eat. And that's the biggest thing that I've learned here. Being a part of the trade house for the last 4 years, not only have I been able to learn how to trade Forex, I've been building a crypto portfolio. I've been leveraging NFTs. You know, I'm now actually starting to get into stocks too. It's insane what I've been able to do, but it's all by sitting at the table consistently. And that's what I'm saying, application, right? The next thing, you guys need to go back and learn from your wins and your losses. Identify what you're doing right and identify what you're doing wrong and create yourself a Venn diagram. I actually talked about this on one of my recorded go live sessions. You guys can go check it out, right? Evaluate your guys' pros and cons. Now, like I said, we're nearing into the last month of this year, right? For the ones that have been here for a year, 2 years, 3 years, even 8 months, have y'all gone back and reflected on every single trade you take in this year? Drop a one in the chat if you have. Be honest. Right? Be honest. Okay? Right? It doesn't look like it. So this kind of goes into the next thing I wanted to talk about, but I'm going to save that here for a second. But that's the thing people forget about. Y'all are taking all of these positions, you're taking all of these trades, but you are not evaluating your progression. Because if you simply don't know what you're doing, how are you going to know how to change to do things better into the future? Right? One thing that I learned from a call that Mike Nav did once, you know, and this was an amazing takeaway. Connect your Forex account, your MT4 account, to MyFX book. And for the ones that don't know what MyFX book is, I don't know why you don't know what that is. First of all, you should already know what that is. But besides, you know, all jokes aside, MyFX book allows you to track your progression. It literally shows you to the T what asset you lose the most to, right? It shows you what your most losing trades are. It gives you all different types of analytics and statistics to help you to see where you're going wrong. This is how you will progress. And I love how a lot of y'all were being honest in the chat, because that's where y'all need to start. You know, if y'all are over leveraging still and not seeing progression, well, come on, fam, you're practicing insanity, aren't you? Right? Are you just executing trades without actually waiting for your limits to hit or your area to hit? Are you just FOMOing into positions? Have you been able to identify these things? Because these are the things that are holding y'all back. See, awareness, and this is what I wanted to get into, right? Awareness is something that I feel like a lot of people forget and don't bring to their attention, right? That's what awareness is, right? Bring yourself to attention of things that you're doing. And this is what I'm mentioning here. You know, awareness doesn't just apply to y'all's, you know, trading in your trading journal. Awareness also applies to maybe a bad habit that you have currently right now that's holding you back. Right? For some of the ones that have been following my Instagram, y'all know that I dropped two of my, you know, habits that I felt like was maybe holding me back a little bit. Well, I felt like it. And I dropped those two habits. I'm on day two right now. I'm pretty tired because I usually use one of those habits to fall asleep. And I literally was tossing and turning for 4 hours last night because I could not fall asleep. Right? And that just goes to show how much I was in need of that thing. And now what I'm doing is I am breaking a habitual pattern by getting rid of these things out of my life. How many of y'all have dropped those habits? Is there something that you're doing right now that you should not be doing during this progression? Yeah, let me be real with you. I've made a lot of sacrifices, and I'm not saying you guys need to make all of these sacrifices like I did. I don't even look at them as sacrifices sacrifice is, I don't even think that's the right word. The way I look at it, these are things that are holding me back that I had to let go of. You know, there was people in my life that I had to let go of that weren't helping me progress. There were things in my life that I was doing that I needed to let go of. These types of things is what you all need to bring to your awareness. You need to understand, right? Because if you don't understand these things, you're going to simply repeat and do the same BS and you're going to expect a different result. And we know insanity repeats itself when you do the same thing, right? So with awareness, this will help you all actually start to change and progress in your future. Because now you will be able to identify the things that are bringing you down. There might be people. One of the, you know, like I said, you know, a lot of the people that I used to talk to in my past life, I don't even speak to anymore. And yeah, I say my past life because I'm a newer, better version of myself now. Okay. I've let go of that. I've let go of, you know, habits that I've, you know, that I saw that I've seen myself, you know, I've quit drinking. Well, daily drinking. I used to be a heavy alcoholic, right? When I used to work at Amazon, I would knock almost 4 to 6 beers a night and watch Netflix or game. That was my regular routine when I used to work. That was one of the first things that I dropped. When I first started Trade House, I dropped drinking, I dropped smoking, and I dropped gaming. 3 of my biggest distractions, and watching television or Netflix, I guess. Who really watches TV anymore? I hate commercials, right? But besides that, right? These are things that needed to be given up. What was another major thing that I also did as well? And it's funny because I actually watched a YouTube video right before I hopped on here from Valuetainment. If y'all don't know who Patrick Bet David is, y'all are sleeping, by the way. Patrick Bet David is the GOAT. Valuetainment YouTube channel. So one of y'all can drop it in the chat. Very valuable content. Hence Valuetainment. Okay. But besides the point, what I'm getting at here is this. In that video, he brought up one major thing that I completely agree with, and it honestly has helped me progress a lot, is leaving my hometown or leaving where I grew up. Because let me tell y'all something, right? You're talking to somebody that, you know, born and raised in Toronto, the dot or the six, right? I hate how they call it the six. And there's a whole rabbit hole I can get in under that, but we're not going to go there today, right? This isn't a Mike Miles session. But, you know, the thing that I want y'all to understand is this. Due to the fact that I was in my hometown for almost, I would say what, like 26 years of my life, 25, 26 years of my life, there's certain things, habits that I continuously will do there. Even though I was in trading and I was doing this, I would still do things that I shouldn't be doing at times. And I'm not telling y'all, pack your bags and just go somewhere. That's not what I'm getting at. But leaving my hometown, that was something that helped me progress. Responsibilities is something that helps people grow. Living on your own, doing things on your own, and being on your own is something that helps people grow and progress. Because guess what? We get comfortable, right? You know, living with certain people, we get comfortable, right? How many of y'all see rich kids that are spoiled and they're completely ungrateful for their life? Why do you think that happens? It's because they're literally in the same place, right? And their parents gave them everything. I actually think that letting a kid go through struggles is probably the best thing that you could do. Putting a kid through poverty is probably the best thing that you could do to them. And that's what I mean. Experience change in your life, however it is. You know, I literally moved to a whole nother country. And I'm actually planning on moving to another country in the next couple of years. Because change needs to happen, right? I'll still have a home in the States. I'll still fly back here. But to be honest, y'all see my skin tone. I need to be back in Asia. I need to be back in my hometown in South Asia. That's where I want to be. right? That's personally where I want to be in Asia, right? But that's the thing, right? Change. Change needs to happen continuously. If it doesn't, you get stuck in the same place, right? Big shout out. I think it's KT that said this. If you're not growing, you are dying. There's no middle ground. There's no, oh yeah, you know, I'm going to just keep doing. No. If you ain't changing things continuously, I'm sorry, family. You dying. That's how this happens. It's either you keep going up or you go down. And change is what helps you continuously grow. All right? So, you know, those are kind of the main things that I wanted to really bring on this call, because this is something that I actually talk about almost every year at the end of the year. If y'all have been on my calls, for the ones that have been here for, I saw some people that were here for like 2-3 years. If you've been on my calls before, y'all know before I get into December, this is what I talk about, because it's time for y'all to start getting ready for 2023 now, right? Not January 1st. Don't start making your New Year's resolution now. Nah, F that. Start now, right? Y'all want to quit that thing New Year's Eve? Do that now. Better yet, don't even celebrate New Year's Eve. Get to work on New Year's. Tomorrow's my birthday. I ain't doing shit. I'm grinding. That's the mentality that I'm in. Because to me, that's what matters, right? Now, I know a lot of people might disagree with this. They're like, oh, bro, but you're only work. It's not work to me, though. I'm obsessed with this. This is a lifestyle for me now. Looking at the charts, living and breathing investments, living and breathing the entrepreneurial life, that's something that is embedded in me now. And that's how much I want this. You know, I'm coming for all of it. And if y'all are as hungry as I am, you know, like the hunger I'm talking about is buying countries type of hunger. I ain't stopping at Millie's. I'm catching Billy's. That's where my head's at. And the only way that's going to happen is through consistent change, right? Because for the ones that, you know, like I said, valuetainment, go watch Patrick Bet-David's videos years ago and compare them to now and see how much that individual has grown. I look up to PBD a lot, right? He's been, you know, the entrepreneur that I've been looking really up to. On top of him, Alex Hormozi and Layla Hormozi, if you guys rock with Mozi Nation, right? These are individuals that I really look up to, especially in entrepreneurial business type of space. But, you know, hopefully y'all were able to take away with what I was mentioning there. But, you know, I see y'all drop in a bunch of questions. So I want to make sure that I give enough time to do that, because y'all already know the GOAT Mike Miles is about to go live here in about 20 minutes and I ain't running over that time. So I want to make sure that I address the questions that are in the chat. So let's go ahead and start diving into things, right? What is your routine leading up to the charts? I kind of answered that already. Literally, bro, wake up, you know, I wake up, brush my teeth, you know, splash some cold water on. I filled my bottle up with some cold water. I down this like right away, and then I fill it up and then I keep going. I personally believe that if you get water in your system in the morning, because you're dehydrated, you didn't drink water for like 6, 8, 5 hours. We are alkaline electric beings that are 70% above water. We need our water. So that's why I drink water in the morning and I'm ready to go, right? And, you know, I pop on a podcast and I'm literally on the charts right after that. Another thing too, my phone is not like, okay, well, that's kind of cap. There's certain times that I am on my phone, but most of the time it's on silent. And the reason why I say sometimes is because, you know, y'all know I got a baby. I got, you know, all of this. So I got to make sure my phone's in vicinity, because if the wifey needs me, she needs me, you know? So, but I have notifications turned off for a lot of things. Number one, Instagram. Okay. That's why, Caesar, when you messaged me at 10:56, I didn't reply right away because I don't have my notifications turned on for Instagram. I think that's one of the biggest distractions. I feel like the only notifications you should have turned on is for people that you need on speed dial type B, right? Those are the types of notifications you have to, y'all should have turned on. Or maybe, you know, the other notifications I've turned on is for our Discord, right? Is for like things that are help income producing activities qualify as notifications for me. For example, Elon Musk, if he tweets, I'm watching that. No cap. I'm subscribed to his tweets. These are things that I put myself in front of. Watch Guru, right? There's a lot of different things that I can mention here, but you know, anything that y'all see as a distraction, y'all should turn off your notifications in the not even in the morning, just turn them off, period. Okay? If y'all turn on your phone right now and you go to screen time, y'all go see how much screen time you're spending on stuff. Y'all need to see that. Because unless if you on your phone actually, you know, calling people, you know, you're running up the business, whatever, y'all shouldn't be on the phone, period. What are y'all on the phone for? Scrolling? Is that helping you make millies, billies? No, it's not, right? That's the main thing. So I make sure all of my distractions are out of the way as well in the morning. And yeah, just drink water and I'm on the charts. I personally have a 4 monitor setup because I need to see a lot of things. I like having 3 charts on 3 of those screens. And then 1 chart is my execution screen. So I literally have TradingView, MetaTrader 4, right? Because I execute everything on thing. I usually have the dollar on one screen, and then I have 2 assets that I'm looking at. Sometimes it'll be gold. Sometimes it'll be indices, whatever's looking nice. I have those on the other 2 screens. Now, I'm not saying you need to have a lot of screens to be an optimal trader. It's just me. I'm a very visual person and I can't operate on a small screen with like the 3 little window thing. It just doesn't work for me. All right, moving on. But yeah, that's really it for my morning routine. I don't do anything special. And this might rub a lot of y'all the wrong way, but I've personally seen a lot of progression. I used to have a morning routine, but I completely threw that out of the window. Because to me, a morning routine, you're getting ready to get ready. And I don't believe in that. You know, you're meditating, you're doing all of this stuff. And I'm not saying meditation is bad. By all means, do it, right? Meditation, maybe I'll write in your affirmation journal, stuff like that. I honestly stopped doing a lot of all that stuff majority of this year. And it was actually a video that I took away from Alex Hormozi, which is an individual that, you know, has multiple businesses and he generates over $100 million a year. And, you know, I listen to people that have things that I want. And, you know, he's somebody that I really look up to. And when he talked about that and he brought that perspective to me, I'm like, yo, that's facts. I literally just get up and I just get going now. I just get to work. That's what I'm getting at. You know, I have a priority list for the day and I follow that priority list, right? I don't make a to-do list because I think to-do lists are kind of eh. Because everybody has a lot of to-do things, but I think everybody needs to create a priority list. What's your priorities for the day? What do you need to get done? You know, and my priorities are hopping on the charts, making sure I'm on go live, right? Making sure I eat, of course, got to fuel the body, right? Because if you ain't fueling the body, you ain't going to be able to work properly. And that's the other thing. Y'all know I'm an alkaline vegan, right? I don't eat meat and stuff like that. Not saying any, you know, y'all need to change to my dietary, what I do, but I personally believe eating healthy food is what brings up like your body is like a car. Right? Think about it. If y'all don't put oil in a car, what happens to it? It's sluggish, right? So the food you eat is very important, right? So that's why I stay away from GMOs. I stay away from chemical-based stuff because I've seen myself perform less, right? I personally believe, you know, I can go really super down a rabbit hole here, but I'm just going to touch on this real quick. You know, my native humanoid is Dravidian, and that's like a human race. And Dravidians were known to just be vegetarians. So my people personally weren't always meat eaters. And what I noticed is once I took meat out of my diet, personally for me, because that's where my heritage, my culture is from, I started to see more progression, right? So that's just me. Find what your thing is. Maybe there's something that you're doing right now on your eating side that's holding you back, right? Maybe stop eating so late, because when you eat late, your body works at night, and that inherently will make you tired in the morning. That's why I literally have dinner at 5, 6 p.m., latest 7. It really depends on my baby boy, but most of the time, like that's, and then I'm going to bed at 10. I'm giving myself optimal time for my body to digest. But let's move on to the next question. For someone that works 9 to 5, do you know good pairs to trade for Asian session? If you are working 9 to 5, because I didn't actually work 9 to 5. I worked 8 to 8 or 7 to 7. I worked like 12, 14 hour shifts at times. I was a swing trader. You know, I would focus on hour, 4 hour time frame and focus on daily, weekly targets. You know, I would set limits. That's kind of the way I would go about it. Now, don't get me wrong. There are trades that happen in Asian session. For example, gold buys this week, amazing 4 hour point of interest, 4 hour point of interest happened during literally Asian session. So there are opportunities during that time, right? But I would say swing trading. And once again, any question that I answer, guys, I'm answering from my perspective of what works for me. That doesn't mean it has to work for you. I'm just giving you guys my opinion. But yeah, me personally, that's how I went about it. When I used to work at Amazon, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m., I'm literally, you know, peak time. I'm, you know, I can't trade New York session, right? So I would literally set limits prior to going to work. So I used to actually wake up early and try to trade London. And the reason why I say try is because if there is a setup, I take it. If not, I don't take it, right? So because I needed to be at work at 7, I made the sacrifice, went to bed earlier so that then I could get up for London and look for setups. And if it didn't happen, I would set limits before New York. That's how I went about that. What is your favorite time to trade? 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. CST. I actually talked about that today on my session. That's, you know, same thing as I told y'all, right? My FX books gives y'all analytics. And what I've noticed is the best times I perform is during then. So I stuck to then, right? Maybe some of y'all perform well during the afternoon session. For an individual like John Fibonacci, y'all know he likes trading indices in the afternoon. That's what works for him, right? I personally trade indices just started recently hopping back on them, but I trade indices during the morning session. That's where I like to perform, right? So it really depends on preference. What are your daily non-negotiables? It's actually funny that I'm actually putting define non-negotiables here on Google, not open to discussion or modification. Okay. I'm not the greatest at English, even though I read a lot of books, but it is what it is. All right. That's honestly a good question. What are your daily non-negotiables? What is not open to discussion? Staying hydrated, hopping on Go Live, educating myself, reading every day, you know, literally those habits that I told y'all, that's on my priority list every single day. So those are my non-negotiables. I need to go outside every single day as well. I forgot to talk about that. I think grounding is very important. Literally taking off your guys' rubber shoes and actually planting your feet into the ground is very important. I go for walks. That's the way I clear my head. Me, Kat, and Roger go on walks literally every single day, you know, or we go to a park or something like that. That's a non-negotiable for me. I'm a nature head. I love the nature. So I'm always outside. How do you conquer gold? It's not even about conquering gold. It's about just when y'all can see in price action in general, I think that, you know, you can trade anything. Really in general. One thing that I have to tell y'all is, especially in the time that we're in right now, y'all have heard me say this, y'all heard Jordan say this, y'all heard multiple people say this, but dollar is daddy. And if you understand where dollar is going, you can trade anything, right? So it doesn't matter if it's gold, silver, indices, Forex, it's irrelevant. Scrolling through here. I know this is when I was asking y'all your trade experience. When did you know it was time to quit your job and trade full time? Oof. Okay, so I took the Jordan Morgan and Mike Miles route of quitting my job. which probably wasn't the best idea, but how do I answer this without putting y'all in the wrong direction? Okay, so because at the end of the day, I'm not your financial advisor. I saved up a lot of money to cover myself for almost like 6 to 12 months worth of, you know, rent and my stuff that I needed to deal with. And I gave myself a window to learn this. Now, I'm not saying y'all can get to that point in 6 to 12 months. That's all what I'm getting at, because, you know, the way I grind and the way you grind is different. You know, I'm not saying I grind harder than you or anything like that. That's not where I'm getting at. But I think that's different and based off of, you know, each individual. I think that once you generate other streams of income and other things are happening, I think it's easier to do that. You know, running up the business and trading is what really helped me in the beginning. No cap. Y'all know I achieved the rank of P5K. I'm currently not that right now, just being fully transparent with y'all, but it is what it is. I have multiple streams of income. I'm not concerned about that, right? But, you know, it is, you know, running up the business as well as trading coinciding really helped me out. And, you know, like I said, just having other streams of income. But if you are going to go around that route, I think it really depends on your finances in particular. What is your best position that, you know, what makes sense to you, essentially? Because I really can't answer that question. But that's kind of what I personally did. You know, I saved up bread and I put myself in that position where I'm like, all right, you know, I didn't give myself a plan B. I'm like, yo, this is what I'm doing. And I just did it. Right. What does it take to be a bounce back educator asking, because I'm up next. You know, having connections obviously is a major thing with, you know, any educator in general. But, you know, having a solid track record, you know, is, and then it's a matter of just, you know, if the company needs an educator in that per said way, then you get in there. You know, there was a demand at the time. They needed me. I got put in, you know, so that's kind of how that is. But yeah, build your track record. You know what I mean? Show consistency. You know, you can't have 1 month where you're following risk management and then have another month where you're over leveraging, right? That's obviously, that's not educator worthy type of results, right? It's like having a resume. How do you form new habits to stay consistent and disciplined in life? So shit, your mindset from cashing money to money works for you. Oh, shift. Okay. Well, that kind of just went out there, huh? I started off one habit at a time, personally, because, you know, y'all, you don't want to bite off more than you can chew, right? And it starts off one thing at a time. Now, this is the way I would tell y'all to do this. I personally started to replace quote unquote bad habits with good habits. So, you know, for example, instead of watching Netflix, I would watch a Go Live. You know what I mean? It's like replacing the thing, right? Instead of listening to, you know, Billboard 100 trash music, I would listen to podcasts. I would listen to motivational stuff, right? That's you got to replace it, right? If y'all can recite Drake lyrics but can't recite Kevin Trudeau or some other entrepreneurial stuff, y'all got your shit twisted. That's all I have to say, right? Especially for the ones that have been following me, y'all know I've been throwing the music industry down the shit. Like, no. Yeah, Billboard 100 music is just trash. This might rub a lot of people the wrong way as well. Bad Money, y'all should look into him as well. Not saying that because there's a lot of Hispanic people on here. I'm just saying, you know, y'all go look into the music. You got to look into who they are and you'll start to understand. Y'all will start to understand smart money ain't just in the charts. Smart money is everywhere. This was one of the biggest takeaways that I took away from Mike Miles, and I took it literally. Reason why I eat the way I eat. I don't eat like everybody else, right? I don't walk, no talk, none of that like everybody else. I shifted everything, right? So don't get Don't get me wrong, though. There are times where it's hard. It's challenging for me to complete. There are times, even when I work out, where I will sometimes listen to that garbage, but it is what it is, man. Like, I'm slowly growing out of it. Because think about it. That's 25 years of listening to trash. I got to now listen to better stuff for a set amount of years to remove that. You know what I'm saying? So I got to refix those neural pathways. Buys on Amazon right now. Amazon actually has that book 40% off right now. So good steal. I believe it's still on Amazon right now. Thank you, Nadia, for dropping the link. Appreciate you. Applied knowledge is power. Yes, yes, yes. Just scrolling through. Yeah, here's the other thing. I know y'all see us trade gold and indices all the time, but like, don't feel obligated that y'all need to be trading these high volatile assets. Okay. Y'all know me. I trade UCHF often because it's nice and slow, low risk, high reward setups, right? Find what works best for you. Just because we look at gold or we look at indices or whatever, that doesn't mean y'all need to go in that way. Find out what it is, right? It's just like music, for example. You know, some of y'all might vibe with one type of music compared to another type of music, right? It's the same thing with trading as well. Maybe some of y'all like the movement of Forex. Maybe others like the movement of commodities, right? It's the same type of ordeal. Nadia, just dropped a friend off of 8 years because she was hella negative. Yo, trust. A lot of the friends that I grew up with, you know, in high school and stuff, you know, they weren't on the same side. They actually were making fun of me because I was doing this whole trading thing. You know, I would go chill with them. I literally dead ass told them I want to take a break. You know, I left WhatsApp groups and stuff because I'm like, yo, I need to deattach. And they felt a type of way. And then I still linked up with them like maybe once or twice a year, you know, because I was, you know, it is what it is. And every time I would go there, it was like a joke. It's like, oh, how's that trading thing going? And I'm like, all right, bro, who's laughing right now? You know? So it is what it is. If people ain't supporting you, they ain't meant to be in your life. Toss them out. Straight up. Straight up. To be completely real with y'all. My dad doesn't even live with me anymore because he was very toxic. He's still taken care of. I'm still watching over him. Everything is good. Like, he's living blessed, but I'm sorry, Pops, but you were too toxic for me. I needed to remove you out of my life. It is what it is. And how many of y'all can actually do that though? How many of y'all can move away from mom and dad? You know? And that's the thing, right? Yo, y'all be blowing up the chat. Mike Miles starts 11 minutes into his session. So we still got some time. So y'all can stay here for a bit. I just decided to move out my family's house because I couldn't focus on my goals. Exactly. You know, for some of y'all, like, that's why I love my mom so much, because she supported me through this the entire way. Maybe some of y'all's parents aren't like that. It is what it is. You know, my pops, like I said, toxic. I had to remove him out. You know, it is what it is. Thank you for dropping the Valuetainment link. Moving if Biden's still president. I personally think that red is coming in house, and I personally think that Trump is going to be in house. 2024 is about to be a lit year. Kanye said himself. But yeah, 2023, if I were to talk chart related and stuff, I think 2023 is about to bring more pain, just like how pain was brought this year. But I think after that pain is done, we're going to have, not I think, after a lot of fear, depression, anxiety, all this stuff happens in the markets, guess what happens after that? Wealth, abundance, prosperity. That's what happens. So just wait on it. Okay. See, I am so subliminally programmed with Migos. When I said wait on it, you know what happened? The ad lib. Wait on it. That's going to that's how programmed this shit is. I'm telling y'all. Y'all think it's a joke. It's really not. Like, I listened to Migos for 10 years of my life. It's still stuck in here, and I'm trying to remove it, you know? How do you balance work and family life? I I give time for both. Like, you know, I'm on the charts and I do my stuff in the morning and whatnot in the rising, my bad. And, you know, I'm on my goal live, stuff like that. I dedicate time in the evening, like after 4 p.m. That's why Caesar, like this call, I shouldn't even be on, right? Like I should be in bed. You know what I'm saying? Like dead ass, I sleep at 10 central, right? But that's what I'm saying though. Like 4 o'clock after 4 p.m. is like my detach time. Like unless like 4 or 5 p.m., like I'm detaching, because after that, that's when I go out for a walk with the fam. Or I go to a park, I spend time with my son, with Kat. And then, you know, I'll come home. We make dinner and stuff, and then we eat. And then after that, it's me just winding down, you know, and I'm getting ready for bed at that point. But that's how I have my routine now. But I personally believe that there is no real balance. It's really, what is your priority right now? Because the way I look at it, because I sacrificed a lot of family time and friend time in my past, that's why I'm able to bring that back in my life now. Because I've hustled in my work and my grind, that now it's possible. What was your paradigm shifting moment? That smart money isn't everything. And I go down every single rabbit hole possible. Like literally right now I'm going a lot through the music, rabbit holes, a lot through the music and fashion industry. I've been learning a lot about that. And it's funny how both of those actually intertwine a lot. Y'all know what's going on with Balenci, but what if I told y'all that was all designer brands? You know me, I ain't buying designer no more. And that's the other thing I actually want to talk about. Rubber shoes, buy leather shoes, buy moccasins. Cause guess what? That stuff still helps you ground. What does rubber do? Rubber repels electricity, does it not? We're electric alkaline beings. So now you're blocking yourself from connecting to Mother Earth. So get rid of them rubber shoes. Just a little food for thought there. Oh, we got Iffy in the house. Yo, what's good, Brody? Almost yelled at the intercom. I was quitting. Okay. All right. Let me keep scrolling. Yo, I appreciate y'all, man. I guess it is 12 o'clock Eastern where y'all are at. So I appreciate y'all for the wishes. Thank you. Appreciate y'all. Damn. Okay. That's why this chat blew up with over 100 messages. All right. I love. Thank you. My mentor Mina says all the time, there's no such thing as balance. It's all rhythm and flow state. Yeah, that's what I believe in as well. You know, it's like, it clicks, you know? Yeah, Balenci be on some next shit. But yeah, Familia, thank you for having me on here. I did my best. I think I answered literally every single question, just like how I do on my Go Lives. But that's the other thing I want to mention to y'all. Caesar said at the beginning of the call, y'all have me 5 times a week. Make sure you hop on my Go Live sessions, right? Because that's where y'all going to get even more nuggets. And I answer literally every single question. For the ones that hop on my Go Lives, you guys know I ain't capping. I answer everything. So make sure you guys take advantage of that. Love and appreciate y'all. Yeah, and y'all already know we be calling ideas out there too, all the time. But love and appreciate y'all. Thank you for having me on this call, Caesar. Much love, Brody. And I'll see y'all at the next convention for whoever's going to be. I'm not going to be in Rotterdam, but I'll be at the next one. I don't know if I'm going to be hitting up Europe, but you know, we'll be here for the American convention. But love and appreciate y'all. Thank you for having me on the call. And don't forget to follow my Instagram. Heist.